గత 15 సంవత్సరాలుగా ఎన్నో వేల మందిని ప్రభుత్వ ఉద్యోగులుగా తీర్చిదిద్దిన సంస్థ హర్షిత్ ఇన్స్టిట్యూట్ ఇప్పుడు ఆన్లైన్ క్లాసెస్ ప్రారంభించిన సందర్భంగా ఏపీ తెలంగాణ గ్రూప్ 2 ఎస్ఐ కానిస్టేబుల్ ఆర్ఆర్బి ఎస్ఎస్సి బ్యాంక్ ఉద్యోగాలకు ఇంగ్లీష్ మరియు తెలుగు మీడియంలలో 2999 రూపాయలకే మరియు ప్రతి సబ్జెక్టును కేవలం 499 రూపాయలకే అందిస్తోంది. పాత ఆర్ఎస్ అగర్వాల్ కొత్త ఆర్ఎస్ అగర్వాల్ రెండు కలిపి 999 రూపాయలకే. ఆర్ఆర్బి 50 ఇంగ్లీష్ మరియు తెలుగు ఆన్లైన్ ఎగ్జామ్స్ కేవలం 99 రూపాయలకే. వివరాలకు హర్షిత్ ఇన్స్టిట్యూట్ మొబైల్ యాప్ని డౌన్లోడ్ చేసుకోండి లేదా 9032200190 లేదా 9676525789ని సంప్రదించవచ్చు. హర్షిత్ ఇన్స్టిట్యూట్, చుట్టుగుంట, ఏలూరు రోడ్, విజయవాడ.
Next system in our body is reproductive system, which is one of the life process. What is meant by reproduction? Reproduction is the ability of the organism to produce the offsprings. And why this reproduction is necessary for an organism means to continue the species. Or let us see the importance. Reproduction. Reproduction is the capacity or ability to produce offsprings is called reproduction. And this reproduction helps to increase the population. Survival of the species, perpetuation or continuation of the race, perpetuation or continuation of race occurs in reproduction. Suppose, think that there is no reproduction in any organism. What happens means all the living organisms come to an end. Why? Because if reproduction is not there, no new organism will be produced in the body. Because either it is a small organism or big organism, no new organism will be produced in the body. If new organism is not produced, there is no increase in the population and there is no survival of the species. For example, if you take dinosaur, dinosaur become extinct. Dinosaur became extinct. That the extinct is nothing but no species is found in the particular organism. So perpetuation of race means continuation of race also does not occur. This reproduction is of two types. Reproduction is of two types. They are asexual reproduction, sexual reproduction. Let us see the differences of asexual to sexual. Asexual reproduction, sexual reproduction. Asexual reproduction is the reproduction in which only one organism is involved. Here, reproduction in which one organism is involved. Coming to this, one or two organisms are involved. Here, gametes are not formed. Here, gametes are formed. You can observe this, the reproduction in which there is no fusion of gametes. No fusion of gametes. Here, fusion of gametes takes place. So, no fusion of gametes. Fusion of gametes takes place. And at the same time, here mitosis division occurs. Here, meiosis followed by mitosis. Meiosis followed by mitosis. And at the same time, here, in asexual reproduction, there is no formation of new characters. Here, new characters, parents, offsprings have the characters similar to parents. Offsprings have characters similar to parents. Offsprings have here in sexual reproduction, offsprings have the characters of father, mother, mother, father, and what do you call that? New characters also will be seen, and some new characters. So here it is not helpful for natural selection. For natural selection, here helpful for natural selection. Here evolution does not take place. Here evolution takes place. So you can observe many differences in between the asexual and sexual. Coming to these, examples are lower organisms such as amoeba, paramecium, euglena, like that. Euglena like that. And here plants, animals. In plants also, some of the asexual reproduction methods will be occurring. But normally, asexual reproduction occurs in lower organisms where it is a reproduction only one organism is involved. But sexual reproduction involves one or two organisms. Here, gametes are not formed. There, gametes are formed. There is no fusion of gametes. There, fusion of gametes takes place. Mitosis division only occurs in asexual reproduction. But in sexual reproduction, meiosis followed by mitosis. Coming to the fifth one, offsprings have characters of similar to the parent in asexual reproduction. But offsprings have both the characters of father and mother and some new characters also in sexual reproduction. Coming to sixth one, it is not helpful for natural selection. And that is helpful for natural selection. Why? Because variations occur. Variations does not occur. You can add another point here. Variations does not occur. Variations does not occur. Variations occur. Variations means some changes in the body. Some changes in the body may be occurring in sexual reproduction but not in asexual reproduction. So, asexual reproduction are the reproduction in which only one organism is involved. And reproduction in which two organisms are involved are called sexual reproduction. Reproduction which involves the fusion of gametes is called sexual reproduction. And reproduction which does not involve the fusion of gametes is called asexual reproduction. And at the same time, we have variations occur in sexual, variations does not occur in asexual. Mitosis division only takes place in asexual. Meiosis followed by mitosis will be seen in asexual. And sexual is helpful for natural selection. Asexual is not helpful for natural selection. And evolution takes place in sexual. Evolution does not take place in asexual. And here offsprings have characters of both the parents in sexual and some new characters also. But no new character will be seen in asexual reproduction, and as no new character is seen in asexual reproduction, they cannot live in any type of environment. So, in addition to these, where two types of reproduction are present, and at the same time, these two types of reproductions are asexual and sexual. Types of asexual reproduction. In these types of asexual reproduction, where we said that no gametes formation will be occurring, and it is occurring in lower organisms only, and in those lower organisms there are many ways of asexual reproduction. Among them, the first one is fission. Fission means division of an organism into new organisms is called fission. Division of an organism into new organisms is called fission. Here, this fission is of two types. They are binary fission. Binary fission means division of an organism into bi, the name itself is indicating, two, into two new organisms are called binary fission. Here, examples are amoeba, paramecium, leishmania. Leishmania donovani causes a disease called occurring to the spleen. And here amoeba divides in any of the direction. Amoeba has no particular shape, hence it will be dividing into equal parts in any direction. But paramecium is having a particular shape like this. It is also known as slipper animalcule, and this paramecium will be dividing into two like this. And leishmania is another structure which is having a structure like this. It will be longitudinally dividing. So, any direction, the amoeba will be dividing into two new two. Paramecium will be dividing transversely only. Leishmania will be dividing longitudinally. So, this is the difference among the three organisms of amoeba, paramecium and leishmania. Binary fission is same. Division by mitosis only it will be occurring. Only mitosis division will occur in binary fission or asexual reproduction. But that binary fission is nothing but what do you call the division of the nucleus into two nuclei. One nuclei will be dividing into two nuclei. That is only the division, and those two nuclei gives rise to formation of cytoplasm afterwards and formation of two new organisms. And another type is multiple fission. Multiple fission means one organism into many organisms. Multiple means many. Example, best example is bacteria you can give. And bacteria, we will add the previous day buttermilk to milk. And when we add the previous day buttermilk to milk, no, automatically what will happen? Number of bacteria will be formed by division called multiple fission. Number of bacteria will be formed by division called multiple fission. And that multiple fission also occurs in another plasmodium called, another protozoan called plasmodium. Plasmodium is responsible for causing the disease called malaria. And malaria, when this plasmodium enters our body, no, suppose this is the cell. And inside the cell plasmodium is there. This will be dividing into number of nuclei like this, which is not surrounded by cytoplasm. Number of nuclei will be formed, but cytoplasm is not surrounded by it. So, as there is no cytoplasm in it, it leads to the, what do you call that, multiple bodies produced from the single body. So, when favorable conditions arise, no, when you get the disease of malaria, all will be released at a time. So, multiple means many. Multiple means many. Coming to the next one, what do you have is budding. Budding, the name itself is indicating. Examples are Hydra, yeast. In yeast, yeast is used, yeast is a unicellular fungi which is used in baking industry already, you know. Yeast is like this. Whenever yeast is undergoing budding, what happens is the nucleus will divide like this. A small projection arises from the body of the yeast, and that small projection gives rise to the entire yeast. And the difference between the yeast and hydra is here, like these, many buds will be forming like this. Chain of buds will be forming in yeast like this. So, chain of buds will be forming in yeast. Because of these chain of buds, we are able to observe many yeast forming at the same time. Example, if you take hydra. Hydra belongs to the phylum Coelenterata like this. This is the hydra, and from the body of the hydra, a small projection will arise like this. A small projection will arise like this from the body of the hydra. And this small projection is called bud. The nucleus will be dividing. The nucleus enters into the body of hydra, and when it develops small tentacles, no, automatically it gives rise to the new hydra. So that is nothing but budding, which is seen in the yeast and hydra. Here also mitosis division only will occur. Coming to the next one, fragmentation. Fragmentation occurs in algae. Example is algae. Particularly example is Spirogyra. Algae, fungi also can be called. So this algae, Spirogyra, will be living in water. And Spirogyra will be like this. Whenever favorable conditions arise, what happens is this Spirogyra divides into number of fragments or pieces. Spirogyra divides into number of fragments or pieces. Whenever they divide into number of fragments like this, each fragment develops into a new Spirogyra. Each fragment develops into a new Spirogyra like this. So in this way, the fragmentation occurs in hydra, Spirogyra. And next one is regeneration. Regeneration means similar to fragmentation, just it will be seen. But by chance, if suppose this is the planaria. So this is planaria. Example is planaria. You know lizard, a well-known example is lizard. In lizard also regeneration occurs, but not up to the entire extent. Regeneration occurs only up to the head part, where if by chance if the body is divided into number of pieces, each piece develops into a new hydra like this. So like this develop. So because of this regeneration, sometimes you may be asked, is regeneration similar to fragmentation? But some difference is there. Fragmentation is an original form of reproduction, but regeneration is not an actual form of reproduction. By chance, sometimes we will be closing the door while a lizard is passing by. When a lizard is passing by, automatically the tail will cut. But the tail will tail is dead. But the lizard body will again produce the tail. So in that way, that last part of the body, starfish, you know, starfish. Starfish belongs to the phylum of Echinodermata. Starfish also produces its one of its arm. Five arms will be there in a starfish. Starfish also produces one of its arm, where that is called the regeneration. And at the same time, you know, hydra. Hydra also, when it divides into number of parts, it will be producing every new part as a new organism, which is called regeneration. And other types of what do you call the sexual reproduction methods are parthenogenesis. And it is done both in plants and animals. Parthenogenesis means nothing but shifting of sexual reproduction to asexual reproduction. Shifting of sexual reproduction to asexual reproduction, where normally in sexual reproduction we have female gamete and male gamete forming the zygote. But here in parthenogenesis, directly female gamete forms zygote. Here in sexual reproduction we said that one or two organisms are involved. Here means if both combine fertilization, it leads to zygote, which forms the new organism. But only the female gamete leads to zygote means it also forms the new organism. And then it occurs in ants, honeybees, wasps. And another one is, you know, in plants, seedless fruits are obtained. Seedless fruits are obtained in plants by a process called parthenocarpy. Parthenocarpy is seen in plants where seedless fruits are obtained. The process is same, where in plants also the male gamete is pollen grain and the female gamete is eggs, where they both join to form the, what do you call that, zygote. But in these particular plants such as pomegranate they have done, and grapes they have done, and at the same time they have done in pear fruit, they obtained seedless fruits. How they obtained seedless fruits means they doesn't allow the male gamete to join with female gamete, but only the female gamete leads to the form of zygote. And this zygote develops into seedless fruits, where the seeds are not seen in the particular fruit. Without the seeds, the fruit formation will be occurring. And the next method of asexual reproduction is, we can observe the spore formation. So fragmentation, regeneration is another method. Example is planaria. Coming to spore formation. Spore formation you can observe in fungus. Take a bread slice. Example is fungus. Rhizopus, particularly bread mold, you know. And take a fresh bread, sprinkle few drops of water on that bread. When you sprinkle few drops of water on that bread, automatically it leads to, and keep it in a cover for one day aside, then the fungus will be seen. Or if you take cooked food present in a box and not opened for one day, leave it for one day, and when you leave it for one day, automatically the next day you can observe the fungus. When you observe the fungus, automatically the fungus forms the spores. Spore is an asexual reproductive body which can survive for years. Why? Because they are covered by a thick protective coat. Covered by thick protective coat. Because of this thick protective coat only, even cyclones occur, floods occur, earthquakes occur, anywhere the spore will not destroy. The spore will be as usual seen anywhere in any environment. So because of this we can say that spores are the asexual reproductive bodies where they can survive for number of years without damaging. When this spores falls on moist soil, you leave the bread which is covered with fungus for one day like that. Then the next day entire bread will be seen with fungus. Why? Because these spores which are on the body of the fungus, they will be there which gives rise to the new fungus. And because of these new fungus, we can observe through the spore formation. So spore formation is another way of asexual reproduction. We have seen fission. Fission is nothing but division of an organism into new organisms. And among these fission, it is of two types, binary fission and multiple fission. Binary fission occurs when division of an organism into two new organisms only. Multiple fission occurs into many organisms. And under binary fission, you can observe examples are paramecium, amoeba, leishmania. And under multiple fission, we can observe the examples of bacteria and plasmodium. And bacteria and plasmodium is responsible for causing the disease called malaria. And budding. Budding is observed in hydra and yeast. Fragmentation is observed in spirogyra. Regeneration is observed in planaria. Parthenogenesis is nothing but shifting of sexual reproduction to asexual reproduction. And that shifting of sexual means to asexual means male and female combined to form the zygote. But here only the female gamete will be forming the zygote. Only the female gamete will be forming the zygote, and this zygote is observed in such a type of zygote formed directly from the female gamete is called parthenocarpic zygote also we will call. This parthenocarpic zygote is seen in observed in ants, honeybees, wasps. Here plants produce seedless fruits by process of parthenocarpy. Process of parthenocarpy is observed in plants, and when you observe in spore formation, spore formation is seen in Rhizopus, a fungus, in plant group only that one, but a separate kingdom is there for Whittaker classification under it. And because of this, we can see that spore formation is observed in Rhizopus fungus on bread or cooked food also. Spore is an asexual reproductive body covered by thick protective coat which can survive for years, and during cyclones or during earthquakes, which asexual reproductive body can survive? If a question is asked like this, spore. Spore can survive in any of the unfavorable condition. In any of the unfavorable condition, spores can survive. But in all the conditions, the remaining asexual reproductive bodies cannot survive. But spores can survive as long as they live. And that too, under cyclone conditions, under unfavorable conditions such as earthquakes, in all those conditions also spores can survive better in the environment. So these are the various forms of asexual reproduction seen in lower organisms. Next, among the one of the type of we can also called as asexual reproduction. Just like asexual reproduction, vegetative reproduction or vegetative propagation also you can call. Vegetative propagation. This vegetative propagation occurs in plants particularly. From vegetative parts, the production of new plants in plants particularly. Production of new plants from vegetative parts. Production of new plants from vegetative parts such as roots, stems, leaves. Okay? Production of new plants from vegetative parts such as roots, stems and leaves. Such a type of propagation is called vegetative propagation. Let us see one by one what are the various examples. Leaves. Examples are bryophyllum. begonia. In this bryophyllum, you can observe, and this plant can be grown in your houses also, where we will call it in Telugu as vamaku, where the thickened leaf will be there in it, and from the margins of the leaf, you can observe here number of buds like this. Margins of the leaves, these buds are called ephiphyllous buds. Ephiphyllous buds. So from the margins of the leaves we can observe number of buds called ephiphyllous buds like this. These buds are called ephiphyllous buds, and these ephiphyllous buds give rise to the new plant like this. Okay, so these ephiphyllous buds give rise to the new plants like this. Okay, and these buds, when they fall on moist soil, they grow into new plant. In this way, from the bryophyllum leaf itself, we can produce number of plants from the margins of the leaves, particularly by a buds called ephiphyllous buds. Coming to the roots. In roots, examples are curry leaf, and where karivepaku chettu, and surrounding the curry leaf plant, sweet potato, carrot, radish, etc. And surrounding the roots of the curry leaf plant, moraiya. The scientific name of curry leaf plant is moraiya. And the surrounding the roots of the curry leaf plant, surrounding the plant, we can observe number of plants arising. Number of plants arising from the curry leaf plant. So, the, such a type of propagation through roots is called vegetative propagation. And coming to stems. From stems particularly, the best practical example what you know is potato. Potato will be having tubers. Produced from tubers, you know this is a potato, and on the potato we have buds like this. Buds like this on the potato. So potato buds will be there. Eyes of potato, we can also call the eyes of potato. And when you want to get a new potato plant, cut the potato with the help of with small eye like structure. When you cut the potato with this eye, then plant it in the soil, then it gives rise to new plant. And you know grass. Grass will be there, spread through structures called runners. And you have one land, open land, which is filled with grass. And you want to clear that grass. Then automatically you cleared the entire area of grass. When you cleared the entire area of grass, what did you observe is, within 4 to 5 days, immediately when it rains, you are able to observe that that grass has been increased more in number due to the horizontal stems spread in the ground. Horizontal stems spread in the ground, when they obtain the favorable conditions, then it leads to the formation of runners, which give rise to a new plant. And coming to stolons, example is Vallisneria. Nerium also you can write. And coming to corms, Colocasia. Coming to corms, Colocasia. And next, coming to another one, suckers, Chrysanthemum. You know, Banti Chettu. And Chamanti, not Banti. Marigold is Banti, Chamanti is Chrysanthemum. And that Chrysanthemum, from the plant itself, when you observe, small plants will come like this. This is the plant, and small plants will come. These are called the suckers. So another one is offsets. Offsets is Pistia plant. So these are the stem modifications where potato is undergone modified stem, where if you cut the potato along with the eye of potato and plant it in soil, automatically it gives rise to the formation of new potato. At the same time, horizontal stems called runners will observe in the ground, and these runners give rise to the formation of grass. And at the same time, Strolans vallisneria, Combs colocasia. Colocasia ante chamadumpa. Colocasia means chamadumpa. Suckers chrysanthemum. Offsets are present in pistia and icornia, you can also call. And another way of this is all occurring through nature. In the nature itself, man is not responsible. Such a type of vegetative propagation is called natural vegetative propagation. And another vegetative propagation which occurs through man is present, called artificial vegetative propagation. And under artificial vegetative propagation, we have three methods. One is cutting, layering, grafting. Cutting means you take hibiscus or nerium, and when you take a hibiscus or nerium plant, take a select a mature stem, and so with a node should be there to that mature stem, and take that cut of the mature stem and plant it in soil. A node is there like this. So after planting in soil, within 2 to 3 months, we get a new plant, the leaf forming and the roots forming here. So that is about cutting. Coming to layering, antu kattadam. Layering is called antu kattadam. A lower branch of the plant will be bent. So this is the stem. Like this, leaves will be present. And you will select a plant. And after selection of a plant, you will select a lower branch, and that lower branch will be bent and kept in the ground like this. Lower branch will be bent and kept in the ground like this. When it is bent and kept in the ground, here a stone is placed. After 2 to 3 months, here a small root system will be formed, and that will be separated from the parent plant and grown as an individual plant. Here the roots will appear, means leaves will come like this, and then it is separated from the parent plant and grown as an individual plant. So that is about layering. In Telugu, we will call it as antu kattadam. Rose will be done, nerium will be done, hibiscus will be done like that. Last one is grafting. In grafting, grafting is done to obtain a desirable character. Desirable character. One scientist has done like this, and he obtained different varieties of mango to a single plant. Different varieties of mangoes to a single plant one scientist has had obtained. That is, he selected one plant with big guava and less taste, and he selected another plant with small guava with more taste, good taste. And he selected two plants, and he selected the big guava plant which is planted in the soil like this. And he went to the small guava plant and brought a branch and attached that branch to this part. He attached like this part and tied it with a cover and tied it with a thread. And after 2 to 3 months, what happens is the both the branches will combine, and the guava which are obtained to this particular part of the plant will be big in size and good in taste. Here the character obtained is called the good taste to the big guava, and the plant which is rooted in soil is called stalk, and the plant which is above the soil is called scion. So stalk provides water and minerals to the scion, and scion provides the good quality to the stalk. Thereby, the fruit which obtained by this plant is of big in size and good in taste. Good taste means more sweet. So because of this, recently in Enadu booklet, a scientist has done grafting to a rose plant where different types of roses were obtained. Different colored roses were obtained to each and every branch. Like this, one scientist has conducted grafting, obtaining different varieties of guava like cheruku rasam, banginipalli, like that different varieties to one plant only by a method called grafting. So this is about vegetative propagation, where in the vegetative propagation there are two methods, two types: natural vegetative propagation, artificial vegetative propagation. Natural means within the nature itself they are able to produce new plants, and those plants are called the vegetative parts, such as roots, stems and leaves, and leaves bryophyllum and begonia. Epiphyllous buds are present in this, and in this epiphyllous buds we have at the margins, and those margins buds will give rise to new plant. And coming to the roots, curry leaf plant, sweet potato, carrot, radish, like this. From the surrounding the roots of the curry leaf plant, we have number of plants obtained. And artificial, coming to the stem part, tubers, potato, runners, grass, horizontal stem spread on the ground, runners, stolons, vallisneria, corms, colocasia, suckers, chrysanthemum, offsets, pistia. So these are the various parts obtained from stems. Coming to the artificial vegetative propagation, we have cutting, layering, grafting are the three methods. Cutting means a mature branch is selected with a node, and it is cut and kept in moist soil. Then within 2 to 3 months we obtain new plants. Layering is a lower branch of the plant will be selected and bent and kept in the ground. When it is bent and kept in the ground, automatically it leads to the formation of new roots within 2 to 3 months. Then it is separated from the parent plant and grown as an individual plant. And lastly, grafting. Grafting is done to obtain the desirable characters. Two plants are selected here. One plant kept in the ground and one plant branch is attached. The plant kept in ground is stalk, stalk, and the branch attached is called scion. Scion. Branch attached to the stalk is called scion. Scion is having the good quality. Here when we attach both the branches by tying with a polythene cover and thread, automatically within 2 to 3 months we will obtain a plant with good big fruits and good taste.